awfully low. You're gonna make me cry if you don't put it louder. A 5'10", 278 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Charles Bacamu! Our next fighter is representing the city of Tempe, Arizona. He stands at 6'7", 242 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jimmy Phillips! Representing the city of Scottsdale, he stands at 5'7", 148 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Steve Butler. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 5'8", 158 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Johnny Carrasco. Representing the city of Chandler, Arizona. He stands at 5'10", 150 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Billy Hoffman. Our next fighter is representing the city of Chandler, Arizona. He stands at 5'9", 146 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Kid Davis. This fighter's representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'10", 159 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jose Rodriguez. Our next fighter's representing the city of Casa Grande. He stands at 5'10". 162 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Pete Morales. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 5'10", 162 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Tim Wagner. Representing the city of Gilbert, Arizona. He's representing the U.S. Marine Corps. He stands at 6'3", 163 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Sean Johnson. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 5'11", 167 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for John Hunter. Stands at 6'1", 174 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jerry De La Cortez. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix. He stands at 6'3", 207 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Eli Harris. Our next fighter is representing the city of Mesa, Arizona. He stands at 5'11", 199 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Keto Andrews. Our next fighter is representing the city of Tempe, Arizona. He stands at 6'4", 177 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mike Smith. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 5'11", 178 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Eric Regan. Eric's father stands at 6'4", 226 pounds. He's representing the city of Austin, Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Lawrence Carter.
I'm one short.
Watch your hands.
Representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'4", 225 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Robert Wilkins. Our next fighter is representing the city of Tempe, Arizona. He stands at 5'11", 190 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Eddie Elamindoy. Next fighter is representing the city of Globe, Arizona. He stands at 6'2", 170 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jeff Horlacher. Our next fighter is representing the city of Mesa, Arizona. He stands at 5'8", 156 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Vito Jones. Our next fighter is representing the city of Scottsdale, Arizona. He stands at 5'8", 156 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Austin Pascucci. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'4", 181 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for J.R. Sudamaker. Next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'2", 185 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Paul Arroyo. Our next fighter is representing the city of Tempe, Arizona. He stands at 6'3", 185 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Luke Hodges. Our next fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'1", 175 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for John the Pop Rock Lancey. And now your main event, ladies and gentlemen. This fighter is representing the city of Phoenix, Arizona. He stands at 6'5", 220 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Richard Gale. Our next fighter is representing the city of Tempe, Arizona. He stands at 6'2", 208 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Matt Lucas.
After they got through with the parade, you could have cut the camera off. You don't need.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare lungs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
All right, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Real quick, I got some news. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, you walk in.
All judges and officials to your positions, please.
Judges. Red. Red, blue. Rick, he's got it over here, so you know. He's got the red over here.
And can I have Jimmy Phillips to the cage?
Is your name John?
No.
Gentlemen, for the kickoff of our centennial fight, on my right in the red corner, he is 5'7" tall, 278 pounds. He's sponsored by Lawless Clothing and is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ground and pounder out of Chandler, Arizona. He's still looking for his first win. Please welcome Charles Buckaloo! And his opponent on the blue corner on my left is 6'5" tall, 242 pounds. He practices at Brahuza Academy and practices Jiu-Jitsu and Muay Thai. Making his debut here tonight, please welcome Jimmy Bulldog Phillips! Third man in the cage, Mr. Neil Sarambach.
Turn it on, Chuck. Hey, Charles, let's go!
Come touch him up. Keep it clean. That's your corner.
Same training. You ready? Turn it up. Let's go.
You ready?
Let's go. Dress it. Go,
Chuck,
go, take
it. Eli Harris to the judges' table, please. All right, Parker, come on, Parker, let me hear you out there.
Keep going! 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 Keep
Let's go, Chuck.
Yeah. There you go.
Side push to the body, Jimmy.
Chuck, you gotta work.
Chuck! Come defend yourself, right?
There you go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's not the friendly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 1 minute, 56 seconds in the first round. Your winner referee stops contest out of the blue corner, Jimmy Bulldog Pillow.
Jimmy, what can I say? Today's your first fight. You came out there with a little tough guy, Chuck Buffalo. He's fought three times. This is your first time. When you were pimped, you know what? When you were hitting him, what was going through your mind?
Out of breath. Just want to get over as quick as possible.
Let me ask you this, were you a little surprised they stopped it, or did you think it was going to continue, or would you have wanted to continue?
I would like to continue and see how it progressed.
Was there any sponsors or friends you want to thank tonight?
I want to thank the man upstairs for giving me my life and this opportunity. Thank my mom, my dad, my wife, my beautiful kids, and all the people at InnerSource Incorporated. The best training center in the world is IITC Training Center.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give this young man a round of applause, Jimmy Phillips.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, for our next bout, I need Steve Bielak to the cage. All right, ladies and gentlemen, for our next bout, on my right in the red corner is 5'8" tall, 148 pounds. He's sponsored by Combat Sports International and practices jiu-jitsu and kickboxing at Locomotive Gym, Allen School of Martial Arts. He is Steve, second to none, Bullard. His opponent on my left in the blue corner is 5'10" tall, 158 pounds. He has a record of 2 wins against no losses and practices jiu-jitsu out of Casa Grande, Arizona, at the Arizona Jiu-Jitsu Academy. Please give a big Phoenix welcome to Johnny Carrasco! Carrasco! Third man in the cage once again is Mr. Neil Sarenbach.
Come on, Johnny, you gotta grab the boot. Let's go.
Trying to sit that guillotine choke. Rockwell, come on. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let me hear you out there.
awesome.
There we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 40 seconds in the first round. Your winner by triangle choke from Casa Grande, Johnny Carrasco!
Johnny, what can I say? Johnny Tabasco Carrasco. Yeah, you're a good man. Always going to your eye on you. I know this fighter in the rear of the wing. He looks intimidating as heck with all those intimidating tattoos. Going into the first round, did you think you were going to submit him that early, or did you think you were going to go into a war with this guy?
With the training we do in Casa Grande, everything's possible.
I noticed you say Casa Grande different than me. I say Casa Grande. Is it Casa Grande?
Yes, Casa Grande.
Casa Grande.
Try and answer this question. If there was a fighter that you want to find the next Rage in the Cage, who would it be?
The one that's 9-0. That's fine.
That's me!
Is there any friends or any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Yeah, I'd like to thank all my family and friends that are supporting me. I'd also like to thank everybody from Arizona Jiu-Jitsu Academy, PD, Odolfo, my boy Keto. You know that's how we roll, Keto. Especially Carlos. Without his training, the same wouldn't be possible.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give this young man a round of applause. Johnny Tabasco Carrasco, representing Casa Grande.
All right, two quick ones, folks. We are going to keep things going. I need Billy Hoffman to the cage. In the red corner, he is 5'7" tall, 150 pounds. He's sponsored by Wildside Fight Gear and is still looking for his first win. He practices MMA at Proving Ground MMA, and he lives in Surprise, Arizona. Please put your hands together for Billy Hoffman! His opponent on my left in the blue corner. Is 5'10" tall, 146 pounds. He has a record of one win against no losses and is from right here in Fountain Hills, where he practices jiu-jitsu at Rage in the Cage Training Center. Please put it together for Ken Davis! Davis! Once again, third man in the ring is Mr. Neil Sarenbach.
Touch him up, boss. Keep it clean. Open hands to the face.
Please, one more time, we'll complete the beautiful
entrance. Oh, yeah, this is... That's right, make sure you get in there, the official Rage in the Cage after party inside the casino. Third round, your winner fighting out of the red corner, Billy Hoffman!
Bobby, you looked awesome tonight. You fought a tough fighter. Let me ask you this question. Going to the third round, how'd you feel? Were you comfortable? Did you think you were winning?
Yeah, I thought, man. We did so much sparring. There's nothing.
When you put that submission, did you feel you were going to submit him? Or were you thinking, oh my God, I better get this because I'm getting a little tired?
I knew it. But the dagger in it was deep, I got him.
Let me ask you this, Bob. Is there any friends or any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Yes, sir. I want to thank my family.
In the red corner. He is 5'9" inches tall, 159 pounds. He's sponsored by Lawless and Devil's Star. Devil's Inc. He has a record of 3 wins against 1 loss and practices jiu-jitsu, boxing, and kickboxing at the RITC Training Center out of Tempe, Arizona. Please welcome Jose Rodriguez. His opponent on my left in the blue corner is 5'7" tall, 162 pounds. He practices jiu-jitsu out of Casa Grande, Arizona, at Arizona Jiu-Jitsu Academy. Please welcome Pete Morales. Morales. Once again, Mr. Neil Sarenbach is our third man in the cage.
Touch
him
up,
boss.
Keep it clean.
Ready?
Ready?
All right, go.
Let's go.
Underhooks.
Guillotine is double under. Guillotine.
Uppercut.
Uppercut. Let's work that uppercut body shot.
Push him down. Come in between the legs.
Under hook. Let's go. Push him off.
Busy.
Throw that knee.
Nice, baby. Keep going.
Right knee. To the body.
Let's go. Knee. You got to score.
Let's go right there. Bang. Nice. Get that under hook. Get the under hook, Jose. Doubles. Pry him up. That's okay. Knee. Right knee. Throw the right. Throw the right. Let's go. Body shot. Dig it. Right hand. Let's go. Body shot. Nice. Let's go. That's okay. Let's go, body. Underhooks. Let's go. Get the underhooks, okay. Underhooks, okay. Let's work underhooks.
Score.
Make sure the Kings fans are pretty quiet tonight. Let me hear you. Come on. Some of the more they hear you, the better show you're gonna get.
Let's go, Jose, be first every time. Underhooks. All he wants to do is play. Underhooks.
Come on, somebody make some noise. Come on now. Get the party started now. Come on.
Right here, body shot. Let's go. Body shot. Go to right hand. Let's go, blast him. Let's go, Jose, steal it right here. Take his
time. All right, man, let's get the ground one, everybody.
Come on, give these guys a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, you're working hard. Come on, give this young lady a round of applause, she worked really hard. She does accept tips, too.
Let's go, Jose.
Here it goes. Come on, folks. Talk to him. Let me hear you.
Under up. Knee. Right knee. Nice. Okay, let's get under it. Let's work under it. Body shot. Punch his leg. Nice.
Get in between his legs.
Let's get under it. He's trying to keep the other side off. Keep in there. Dead leg. Get him off. He wants to. This is a fight. Let's fight him, Jose. Turn it up. Let's go, Jose. No breakdown. Underhooks. Let's go. Let's go play. Move. Stand him up. There you go. Jose, no takedown.
guys. There's no hugging in MMA.
What do you say we separate these guys so they can real fight? Come on, somebody make some noise.
Come on, let me hear you call. Down, yeah. Folks, here we go, round three.
Let's go,
kick out, come on. Let's go. Make sure you come on over here and get your free sample of Vegas Fuel energy drink.
Come on, somebody make some noise. We got the third and final round. Come on, get these guys popped up.
That's right, talk to it, everybody.
Knees, stand him up. Let's go, Jose. Push it again. Uppercut. Let's go, Jose. Let's score the whole round while you hold your leg. Uppercuts to the bottom. Dig them in. Drop your hips. Let's get the head down, Jose. Let's win.
10 seconds. Let's go.
Let's go, Jose.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Give these two guys a round of applause. They worked really hard for three rounds. Come on.
Judges voted unanimously for your winner, fighting out of the red corner, Jose Rodriguez! Rodriguez.
Jose, congratulations. You fought one of the toughest fighters in your division, Pete Morales. It was very, 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 very tough. Going into the third round, how'd you feel? I know you've been sick for a while, and you took the fight even though...
I mean, I felt all right. I mean, you know, it was tough. I wanted to keep it on my feet, and it didn't go my plan, but to win, you know.
Is there any particular fighter that you want to fight in the next Rage in the Cage?
No, whoever can.
Is there any friends or any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Yeah, I want to thank the RTC Training Center, all my friends that came out to support me, you for sparring with me, Austin.
Want to say that again? Who sparred with
me? You. Roland sparred with me every day. I want to thank Austin, Jordan, Richard Hill, my quarterman, and my GT Cook, Jason Hart, and Ty, for everything, and my sponsors, Lala, Chloe, and Double V.
Is there anybody else you want to thank or you want to just thank Mike Golden? Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jose Rodriguez.
Hi. In the red corner. He is 6'3" tall, 162 pounds. He has a record of one win against no losses and practices mixed martial arts at Elite Combat Sports in Glendale, Arizona. Please put your hands together for Tim Wagoner. His opponent on my left in the blue corner is 5'11" tall, 163 pounds. He has a record of two wins against one loss and is sponsored by the RITC Training Center, G Vegas Clothing, and Zuma Grill. He is from the United States Marine Corps. And he practices MMA at the RITC Training Center. He is Sean the Shadow Johnson! Third man in the cage once again, Mr. Neil Sarabot.
Come on, draw him. Let's go. Draw a job to do.
You ready?
We're going up. Let's go.
Come on, somebody make some noise here. Come on, y'all. What is it? This is a cage fight. Somebody get into it. Make some noise. Come on.
Okay, you lost it, Jim.
Come on, go ahead, get out of there. Go ahead, get out of there.
Christmas, can I see you please? Merry Christmas.
Yeah!
kicks on doors for the third and final round.
Give them that energy, man. They've been going at it. Oh yeah, ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 53 seconds. In the third round, your winner by submission, guillotine choke, out of the red corner, Tim Wagoner!
What can I say? What can I say? You came into the third round. Here, look this way. Here you go. Come on. Here you go. Look this way. Sit the corners, and here you go. You can't open it up. Anyways, you went into the third round. You knew it was a dogfight. It looked like the fight could have went either way. When you put him in that guillotine hole, did you feel that you were going to submit him?
Well, I knew that was pretty deep already. I just needed to crank my hand a little bit and just make sure that I didn't get on my wrist before I started to lock it in. And yeah, I pretty much knew it was a pretty fight. Yeah, I want to give up to him. The one blow completely accidental. That's not professional at all. That's an accident. And that's my deepest apologies. And that guy right there, he's a real soldier. He gives up, he represents our country. And he's all safe. All the people, give it up for him. I want to thank the Heat Combat Sport, Matt Spencer, and the great John Vieira, my family and friends for coming to support me. My girlfriend, I love you. And last but definitely not least, my personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, give this young man a round of applause. Rick, I got some good news. We're going to go into our first intermission, but when we come back, we're going to give away a free...
John Hunter to the cage! In the red corner, he's 5'11" tall, 167 pounds. Still looking for his first win. He's a freestyle fighter out of Queen Creek, Arizona. Please put it together for John Hunter! Hunter! His opponent on my left in the blue corner is 6 feet tall, 174 pounds. He has a record of 1 win against no losses, and he practices jiu-jitsu out of Phoenix, Arizona, at the Rage of the Cage Training Center. Please welcome Jerry Delaportes! Delaportes! Your man in the cage once again is Mr. Neil Saraba.
Just come touch him up, guys. Keep it clean, okay?
There you go. There you go.
fucking combo from here.
Let's go, John!
Let's bust you up like a combo, come back down. There you go, right now.
Down the chest.
If the guy who wanted to see you dance and make some noise, they might do that. I don't know.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, first off, put your hands together for both of these fighters. Taking it all three rounds. Once again, there is only one winner, and the judges have voted unanimously for your winner fighting out of the blue corner, Jerry De La Puerta.
Jerry, you came out there, you fought a guy that gave you everything. He almost took everything out of you, but you hung in there real tight. He almost submitted you a few times with the guillotine. Was there ever one that was kind of close where you thought, oh boy, can I get out of this one?
No, I thought I could get out of them all, but that guy was tough. As he was tough. Give it up for him. He gave me a lot. But I wasn't really scared of the submissions or anything.
Let me ask you, going into the third round, did you feel that you were ahead or you were behind?
I thought I was ahead with my takedowns and my striking. But it was close though. I mean, I could have came down in the third round, but I'm pretty sure I put them away.
Is there any friends or any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Yeah, I want to thank my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, my partner Jason, my girlfriend, and my parents, my father, everybody, you know, Ty. Oh, thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Jerry De La Cortes.
That's what it's all about, folks. All right, we're going to keep things rolling here. I need Eli Harris to the cage. You guys know who that is?
Kiko Andrews, representing the city of Casa Grande. Do we have any Casa Grande fans? Make some noise here. Come on, guys, make some noise out
in the red corner. 6'2" tall, 217 pounds. He's sponsored by Wallside Fight Gear. He's the one rocking the hawk right there. Red Mohawk, that's right. He has a record of 2 wins and no losses. He's a Muay Thai fighter. And practices jiu-jitsu out of Surprise, Arizona. And proving ground every day, he is Eli Harris. The throwing Samoan. His opponent on my left in the blue corner. 5'11" tall, 199 pounds. He practices Brazilian jiu-jitsu and boxing. The Arizona Jiu-Jitsu Academy in Casa Grande, Arizona, originally from Sacramento, California, is Tito Andrews! Third man in the cage once again, Mr. Neil Serenbach.
In case you don't know, Tito's nickname is Mickey Mouse.
Go!
grabbing shorts. Now grabbing the shorts. Watch your groin, watch your groin.
Come on.
if you like this fight, somebody make some noise for these two young men. They really put it out. I mean, these guys, they really put it out on the line. This is the fight of the night. How many people think that the song Samoan won tonight? How many people think that Kano won tonight, make some noise? You just want to see some fights, make some noise. All right, you guys are waking up a little bit. I like that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again going to the third round, the judges have scored it unanimously. Your winner, fighting out of the blue corner, Kano Hondo!
Kano, what can I say? I would have to say you're one of the most electrifying fighters I've seen in the history of Rage in the Cage. I know you're 2-1. I know in your recent fight, you got a defeat, but you came back with a victory. Going into the third round with the throwing Samoan, did you feel comfortable on the scorecard? You know what? Really, I didn't pay attention. All I could hear was my trainer, Carlos, yelling at me. He's probably going to be pretty hard on me next week because I gassed out a little at the end. It was a great fight, man. His head is solid, man. But all I'm really waiting for is to get these five fights in so I can close these fists up. And I promise you, Reggie, in case you're going to see a knockout. I promise you that. I'm talking to you. Well, I think the reason his head was so big because he had the Rana Matana Mohawk. That's why, you know, I gave him a lot of protection. Pretty much, Keto, is there any friends or sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Yeah, I want to go holler to my cousin. See you, Gavin Bees, where you at? Who you with? Hey, everyone in Arizona Jiu-Jitsu Academy, we put 400% in this every day, baby. 400%, that's all we do.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give this young man a round of applause, Keto Andrews. Can you get it going one more time? I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Okay. There you go.
All right. Next fight. That's right. Someone's going to help out. Thank you. Thanks for helping me out. I need Michael Smith to the cage. Musica.
I like your pants around your knees.
What a swimmer, boy.
He is 6'2" tall, 177 pounds. He has an even record of 2 wins and 2 losses. He practices Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu out of Tempe, Arizona, where he fights at the Rage of the Cage Training Center. Please welcome Michael the Spartan, Smith! His opponent on my left in the blue corner has a record of 5 wins and 4 losses. He's 5'9", tall, 178 pounds. He fights in my warning label fight gear and practices American Jiu-Jitsu at the American Martial Arts Center, Team America. Please welcome Eric Regan! Third man in the cage, Mr. Neil Sarenbach.
Just come touch it up, guys. Just touch it up, don't get started. Keep it clean. Ready?
Oh, see. Come on, Eric, triangle.
Watch your skin out, boy. Let's hang on that thing.
your toes, bro. Let's go, ankle, ankle, ankle. Two legs down, hip in. Stay knee bar, stay knee bar, stay knee bar. Right there, knee bar. Pass, pass. Mike, let's pass. Let's keep the combinations coming, Mike.
Hey, Rex.
Doing the move, countering, rebounding.
Let's go.
stand up, finish out with the flow here.
Come on, guys. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, came down to decision by the judges, and they have voted unanimously for your winner, fighting out of the blue corner, Eric Reagan!
Eric, what can I say? You're one of the toughest fighters in the range of the cage. You went head-to-head with Mike Smith. Or the dog fight going into the third round. Did you honestly feel like you won that fight?
No! I never stopped winning.
Eric, as you know, you're the Geico man. You're gonna be a movie star. How many people see him in commercials? The Geico commercial. Eric, you're all right. I've been known Eric for several years, one of my favorite fighters. Are there any friends or sponsors you want to thank tonight?
I want to be able to fight here. My training partners, my mom, and my baby who's in Texas.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Eric Reagan!
It would be a huge fuck if I got a huge belly. He is 6'1" and just tall, 226 pounds. Originally from Rosebud, Texas, he's a street fighter and a subacto at Whisk. Please welcome Loris Sampson Staton! His opponent on my left in the blue corner is from Winslow, Arizona. And he is 5'10" and just tall, 225 pounds. He has an even record of one win against one loss. He practices mixed martial arts at Rage in the Cage Training Center. Please welcome Robert Wilmans! Once again, Neil Sarenbach is our third man in the cage.
Just come touch him up, boss.
Let's go!
team.
There you go. Stay with it. Stay with it. Stay with it. Stay with it.
How many people want to see these guys stand up and make some noise? Come on. Rage in the Cage Ring Girl Contest. It's going to take a little 5-minute intermission meanwhile.
Go to work with the hand, Rob. Go to work with
fuel left.
Get us some
energy, folks. Come on. Let's go. Let's go.
Right leg left. Right leg left.
Push it.
You have a play, Mason.
Rock it now, rock it! Let's go, get your head out!
Breathe it! Breathe!
Get off!
Take a bounce from the start, maybe you're not gonna do something. Same position.
Let's go, baby, let's go! Third round door! Third round door! Get
deep down! Come on now. Don't let him get that arm, don't let him get that arm! Don't let him get that arm!
But meanwhile, we're going to be doing the Rage in the Cage Ring Girl contest as well. With a 5-minute intermission, then we're going to finish off the night with the 5 super fights. So Hogan, hold on tight.
Let's go, guys.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the officials have voted unanimously for your winner out of the blue corner, Robert Wilburn.
Robert, what can I say? You guys showed a lot of good sportsmanship. That's right, guys. Robert, what can I say? You got out there once again. You got a victory. You're 2-1. You look fantastic. You fought a stud over there out of Texas. I flew all the way here just to fight you. Now, going into the third round, did you honestly feel you won that fight?
Yeah, I thought I outscored him. Well, he's a tough guy. Huh. I guess. I guess I got to go down to the corner.
Are there any friends or any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Oh, all my fans that came out. Yeah. Well, it's for you, buddy. All my fans, I love you guys. Roland, thank you. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't have this opportunity. All the guys at RATC, love you guys. Be looking for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give this young man a round of applause. We're going to take a fight for fight. Somebody make some noise. I know it's been a long night. We had a lot of fights. We had our fair four fights and less fights. But the next fight fights, how about our super fights? Get ready. Get ready to rumble.
By Tap Out Fight Gear and has a 2-1 record. He's from Claypool, Arizona, where he fights jiu-jitsu out of Team Insane. He is Jeff Stutzkilla Horlocker! Stutzkilla Horlocker. Third man in the cage, Mr. Neil Sarabon.
Okay, just come touch him up, guys. Just come touch it up. Keep it clean.
Defense.
You
ready? Come on! Come on! Come
on! Come on!
Make some noise here. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Congratulate each other. Good job, guys.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you saw it. Damn quick. The official time, 12 seconds in the first round. Your winner by knockout, fighting out of the blue corner, Jeff Stutzkilla.
Jeff, let's wrap this up. Don't worry, we'll go with that, Jeff. You looked outstanding. You know, they don't call you the Stutzkilla for nothing. You came out there, I would have to say that's probably one of the quickest knockouts in the history of Rage in the Cage. Is that what you were trying to do? That's all day, baby. I have my corner, Jamie Barnum, UFC fighter, said, I want one punch. I want you to end him in one punch down the pipe. I said, I gotta listen to this guy. He's in the UFC.
So if it wasn't for him, I might have took two or three punches. I don't know.
Yeah! Thank you, man. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Jeff Suskler Hollander.
I told you these are the super fights.
Knock out. All right, we're going to keep this going. I need Tito Jones to the cage.
These two lightweights that are currently entering the cage right now are two of the best in the country, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be the fight of the night right here. We're coming up. This is going to be the fight of the night right here. This fight's going to be electrified. Non-stop action.
He's a former U.S. Marine Corps fighter. He is representing the United States Marine Corps. He is a second shot at the Felician.
And this is Julian. On my right, in the red corner, he is 5'9" tall, 156 pounds. He's sponsored by Soyo.com and MTX Audio. And originally from Panama City Beach, Florida, he's a freestyle fighter at Arizona Combat Sports. Please welcome Tito Lil Dirty Joe!
Let's go, Tito!
And his opponent on my left, in the blue corner, he is 5'6" tall, 156 pounds. He's sponsored by Action Signs, Raging the Gate Training Center, and the United States Marine Corps. He has a record of 7 wins and 5 losses, a freestyle fighter out of Scottsdale, Arizona. He is Austin the Punisher, Pascucci! In the cage for our super fight is Mr. Neil Saramba. Here we go.
Let's go. Get him. Let's go. Hey, you give it to him. You bring it. Ready? Go take it. You got it, Gil. Go it. Heck, you see it. You see it, Gil. Yeah, let those hands go. Let those hands go. Get out and stand up. Keep that leg trapped, Tito. Keep that leg trapped. Two on one leg. Two on one that leg. That's nothing. That's a slap. There you go. There you go. Hit him with that deuce. Hit him with that deuce, Tito. Let's go. 3-2. 3-2. 3-2 right now. 3-2. 3-2. You see it, Tito. Uh-oh. Good work, Tito. Push away! Go push away again!
That's what I'm talking to. Come on, fight back! Let me hear you out there!
Somebody next to the others, come on now!
Tito, knee in the butt. Knee in the butt. Tito, let him in. Stand him up. This guy's got to do his crap on the bottom. Stand him up. Tito, get up. Stand him up. There's nothing, no action.
Come on, guys. Let's work.
Not even moving his hips. Stand. Jump up.
All right, here we go. Come on. 3-2.
Go that 2, Tito.
Thank you.
We're just waiting for the fight, Doctor. We're going to be starting in a few seconds.
He is 5'11" tall, 181 pounds. He has a record of 2 wins against no losses, and is sponsored by Yes It Hurts Fight Gear and Live Back Tattoo. He's a kickboxer and practices jiu-jitsu out of Torrance, Colorado, where he fights an attitude first. Please give an Arizona welcome to JR Bone Crusher! Schumacher! His opponent on my left. He is 5'11" tall, 185 pounds. He's sponsored by Warning Label Fight Gear and practices American Jiu-Jitsu at the American Martial Arts Center, Team America. Please welcome Paul Bulletproof Arroyo! This is for the Rage in the Cage Middleweight Championship. Once again, this is for the championship, ladies and gentlemen. Third man in the cage, Mr. Neil Cinema.
Just come touch him up, guys. Keep it clean, eh?
Ladies and gentlemen.
This was a title fight. Let's see, where are you?
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, come on everybody. The official time was 25 seconds in the first round. Your winner and new champion is J.R. Schumacher!
That's right, he is the new Rage in the Cage World Champion. Let's wrap that belt around. What can I say? I mean, you went out there, you fought one of the toughest fighters, the champion of the Rage in the Cage division. Did you feel when you hit him? Did you feel you were gonna finish him at that point?
I just take it to however I feel comfortable. I felt comfortable when he took the blue team, peeled it off, and I went for it as best I could.
Hey,
I just want to thank everybody at Attitude First, Mike DeLawrence, all my training partners, all my sponsors, and I'd like to give a special thanks to my girlfriend Janet. She's been with me along this battle. I just want to thank all the fans out here tonight. Hope you guys enjoyed the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, give this young man a round.
Hodges to the cage.
Hey, cameraman.
Of our next bout. On my right in the red corner, he is 5'10", which is tall, 185 pounds. He has a record of 3 wins against 1 loss and is sponsored by Soyo and Arizona Combat Sports. He practices mixed martial arts at Arizona Combat Sports. Please welcome Luke Hodges! Hodges! His opponent on my left, making his return to the cage. He is 6 feet tall, 175 pounds. He has a record of 17 wins against 7 losses. He's a Muay Thai fighter out of Tempe, where he fights at Mr. Chino Muay Thai. Please welcome John Top Walk Lansing! Lansing! Once again, Mr. Neil Sarenbach is our third man in the cage.
Okay, come touch him up. Come on.
Come on, come on, ladies and gentlemen, give these guys a round of applause. Here we go. This is going to be a good fight.
Hold him right here. Hold him right here.
I'm good.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, big man, stop your clock. Looking for another knockout poker, come on!
Back out throw, Luke! Back out throw! Right hand, straight! Tight clinch, Luke! Tight clinch, elbows in! Push away! Push away!
Watch your groin!
Lead leg, right now! Underhooks! Push away, Luke! Push away and throw! Right hand down the pipe! Underhooks, Luke. Lead leg again.
Oh, okay? Hold up.
Hey, Luke.
Down to 5 minutes.
Luke. Right hand down the pipe.
Hey! Right hand down the pipe.
Don't
cross the pipe. Yes! We now have the We do want to thank everyone right here at Portland Town, Casino, Dallas Flying Nation, for the help of the Financial Bank.
Luke, back out! Back away, push away!
Here!
Watch the last one!
To the face on the floor, just remember.
Right hand down the pipe. Right hand. Three, two. Tight clinch. Underhooks. Two of them. Get both of them.
Inside control.
Push through the half. Push through the half. Push.
matter right after this fight that's going to be the main event.
Put your hands together for both fighters. Come on, everybody. All right. Now for the official word. Ladies and gentlemen, the official time was 2:08 in the second round. Your winner, referee, stops contest, Luke Hodges!
Luke, we're going to say you beat a veteran in the Rage in the Cage, John Lansing, who's been around for many, many years. You came out there, you pretty much opposed your will, you pretty much ground and pound. Did you feel you were going to finish him off at the end?
Well, he seemed like he was pretty tough. He wasn't really about to quit or anything. But I wasn't sure, honestly.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Luke Hodges. Oh, here we go.
Thank you, LG Sports Marketing, Soyo, and Arizona Combat Sports for talking to me.
Fighter and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu artist from Maricopa, Arizona, where he trains at the Rigs in the Cage Training Center. Please welcome Richard Rare Breed Hale. His opponent on my left in the blue corner is sponsored by Smitty Dental, Arizona Power Car Wash, Big Daddy's Grill of Queen Creek, and Confirmation YMCA of Queen Creek. He is 6 feet tall, 208 pounds. He has a perfect record of 6 wins against no losses. Three-star fighter from Queen Creek, Arizona, where he fights in Southwest Mixed Martial Arts, YMCA. He is Matt Luke Duke. Once again, Mr. Neil Sarenbach is our third man in the cage.
Watch your right hand. Keep your hands up. We're not rich. Don't touch him up, guys.
See that teeth? You just told him. Right hand.
That's it.
Ready?
Right hand. Let's go. Keep it up.
Marco, come on. Here we go. Right in the cage, man.
Just pop you out, just hip out. Keep it sweet.
Yeah, man,
this
come on.
Pitch. Don't let it pass. Nice, nice. Hip up.
Come on, man.
Gotta get an angle on
body, body, head. Body, body.
The Bird Fight Band is trying to come on. Don't be shy. This is your main event. This is for you guys.
Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on.
Don't forget, folks, after this fight, in the casino, meet and greet, make sure you go on in. We want to thank everyone right here at Corporate Down Casino. Have a kind evening for their help with tonight's event.
Over!
20, come on,
Matt! Rich, you gotta strike it! Rich, strike him in the hand. Let's go.
Come on, work it.
Strike to make the
change. Come on, man.
Whoop that ass. Come on, man. That's round one, everybody.
Keep going! Keep going! Keep your body! Body shot! Body shot!
Keep going.
Pump it up. Pump the arms. Pump the arms.
30 to go, buddy. 30 to go. Let's go. Come on. That's it. Keep going. Don't stop. Keep going. Hit.
Good job.
Jackson, fighting out of the blue corner, Lucy Newman.
Mad Cameron Man, Mad Lucas, you did it once again. You stepped up, you fought a bigger man. What can I say? You win three rounds. Did you expect this fight to go three rounds?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's your heavyweight champion out here, so he's no joke. Great athlete, great kickboxing. You know, I took it to him with my game plan. And he'll pull off the win. He's a tough competitor. He's a champ, so.
I noticed early on you pretty much took away his stand-up by taking him down like a wrestler. In case you all don't know, Matt Lewis is, a three-time All-American wrestler, two-time All-American wrestler. And then your strategy was obviously to kind of punch, take him down, and control him.
Yeah, he had about a foot on me, so his reach was a little bit longer than mine. But I had to kind of take him down. That'd be the best way to take someone like that out of the match.
Matt, let me ask you this. There's any friends, any sponsors you want to thank tonight?
Absolutely. My wife just had a baby on Thursday. I have to thank her. I came right from the hospital to Rivera, almost got out of the fight. Told Ron I couldn't fight because of her. The baby's healthy, good. Took him on today and came over and fought with Dave Kerr. Arizona Power Car Wash Charles, I screwed that up, I'm sorry. Smicky Dental, hey, best mouthpieces, best dentist, guys. He's out of Tucson. You know, Kevin Smicky was best running back in Arizona history for a while. He's doing teeth, he does a good job. Big Daddy's, they help out, support the best food out in Queen Creek. Thanks, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I got in my corner. YMCA, Tony Lynn. Help me out, John Hunter, your wife, he's coming up amateur watching down the road. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Matt Lewis.